everybody, today I'm going to share with you how to make a really easy shower bomb recipe. All you need is baking soda, citric acid, and it sounds unsafe. It's not unsafe. It's like you can use it in food and stuff. I buy a decent sized bag off Amazon and it's like $7. So I'll link that below. Actually, last time Andy bought me, I've been into making shower stuff. I've made bath bombs. I've been having so much fun lately making stuff. And I ran out, and then Andy bought me the 5-pound bag, which was even cheaper. So I'll link both of those below so you can check it out. But yeah, I got it on Amazon. So baking soda, citric acid, water, essential oil, and food coloring, which is optional. So that's all you need. And it really takes like minutes to make. It's so easy. And it dries within an hour. It's nuts. It's really nuts. It's really fun. So if you follow me on Pinterest, you have probably seen me pinning all sorts of different shower bomb recipes. And there are so many. There's some that you bake in the oven, and then after they're completely hard, you add the essential oil and then you put them in a jar to use them. But the recipe I chose to do today, I will link the blog post below. I can't think of the name. It's an interesting name. But the pin is below, but what you do is you basically make it kind of like you do with the bath bombs, and you put them in your molds, and then that's it. They're done. Super easy. So on to the footage of me making these bath bombs. To make these shower bombs, you need 2 cups of baking soda, 1/2 cup of citric acid, you need 1.5 tablespoons of water, some essential oil. I'm using peppermint essential oil, and you don't need to, but I'm going to use some food coloring. And then you need a big mixing bowl to mix it all in, and then the silicone molds. I'm going to try this one, and then I'm also going to try these because I've never made these before, so I thought it'd be nice to give an option to see what works better. So let's get to it. So the first thing you do is you mix your baking soda and your citric acid, and you can just whisk those together. Once you whisk your citric acid and your baking soda, then to the water you add your essential oil and your food coloring. Next, you just slowly add this mixture to this mixture, just like drop by drop as you're stirring. It's actually super easy. I've done this with bath bombs. And you just kind of take one hand. I can't show it because I need 2 hands. But you take one hand and stir as you're slowly dropping little drops with this. So that's what's next. So I actually found this dropper, and this works so well. It works to pour it little by little too, because that's what I've always done before. But this dropper actually works pretty good, really good actually. So there it is. It only took a few minutes. This is so quick and so easy. And you can see that it molds nicely, so it's all ready to put in my molds. It smells really, really good. Now you just take this mixture and you put it in your molds. So that is what I'm going to do. This recipe makes a whole bunch. Look, I made all of these muffin tins. I hope these turn out because I think these worked the best, I thought. I made all of the hearts. I made some starfish. I tried out the fish. And then I wanted to see, it said silicone, but I wanted to see what it would do with a mini muffin tin because I really think that this would be the perfect size. So if they pop out of here when they're dry, I think that would be the way to go. So I'm going to let these dry, and then after an hour it says to pop them out and let them dry in a cooling rack, and then they should be good to go. These dried really quick. I mean, they're really, really hard right now. Super hard. So they just like pop right out of the thing. So there they are. So we'll see if the rest come out this easily. The hearts just popped right out. I just tipped it over and they all fell out. Look at how cute. And these little starfish turned out cute. The fish did not work out. The tails got stuck. So part of the tails got stuck in there. So don't use those. And these do not budge. I cannot get these out. They're stuck in here. So definitely you want to use the silicone like they said. But I'm glad I tried it so I know. But yeah, I definitely would say these are the best. I like the size of them. These are cute, but I think the size of these are best for shower. Look at how cute they turned out. I like them. Now we have to just test them and to see if they work in the shower. Here they are. I put all the little ones in this big mason jar, and then these muffin tin ones, the bigger ones, they fit actually perfectly
in this small mason jar, which is so cute. There's two of them fit in here. If I only, I think it'd be better to have a bigger one that you could fit four in, and it would make a nice gift.
These were so much fun. Our entire family liked them. Charlie even put them in the bathtub. The kids loved them in the shower. Andy loved them. They're really, really fun. They disappear pretty quick if you're in like a small shower. But the shower that I use that has a tub, I put it at the very far end of the tub where the water doesn't even hit it, and it lasts a lot longer. It really takes a long time for it to dissolve. And it's not as fragrant as I wanted it to be, but I didn't use a super high quality essential oil. I was trying to get rid of actually this kind of junky peppermint that I have. But if you had a really good quality one, I think it would be really nice. I could smell this. It was nice, but it works best. I took them since it wasn't as fragrant as I wanted it to be. I took the essential oil and I put a drop on top of the dried one before I got in the shower, and that really, really is nice. So I can see how the other ones work as well, that you dry them and then put the essential oil on. So I think any of the recipes would work. I would either use a higher quality essential oil or just use more of it if you're using like a lower quality one, if that makes sense. But I definitely give this recipe a thumbs up. We really, our whole family enjoyed them. Thank you for watching, guys. I'm gonna link my other Pinterest videos. I have a ton, I wanna say almost 100 Pinterest recipes that I've tried over the past, I don't know, 3 or 4 years. I will link that here so you guys can see, check out any other recipes, because it's so fun. I love Pinterest. And go follow me on Pinterest. Not many people have followed me there, so definitely go do that. All right, guys, thank you for watching. I will see you soon. Bye.